Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to customize the WordPress LMS theme so you can create your unique and beautiful LMS site. From the WordPress dashboard, navigate to Appearance and Customize. Here's the customizer of WordPress LMS theme. As you can see, there are a lot of settings that allow you to change anything on the website. First, take a look at the general settings. You can change several things here, including logo, layout, styling, typography, extra features, and custom CSS. In logo settings, you can change your site's logo, which appears here on the header. I will choose another image from the library and see how it looks like. As you can see, the new logo has replaced the old one. You can also remove the site logo completely and we'll only see the WP LMS text. I will put it back to the default logo. The sticky logo is the logo when you scroll the page. You can change it with your own logo just like the site's logo. If no image selected, it will just use the default logo. The Retina logo is the same as the normal logo, but twice the size for sharper display on Retina display devices, such as a MacBook. You can also adjust the size logo by changing the logo width settings. I will put it to 200 pixels, and you can see that the logo gets smaller. The site icon is the small image on the web browser tab. You can also change it to whatever you like, but make sure that it has to be at least 512 pixels of width and height. In layout settings, you can change the layout of the whole site, archive page, and single page. You can set the site's content text the full width, like it is right now, or just box style. For archive and single page, you are allowed to have sidebar on any side, or even both. In styling settings, you can set the primary color of your site. You can see the change in the back to top button. You can change the main content background to color background, image background, or pattern background. If you previously choose the box content layout in the layout settings, which I will change it to now, you will have the same option to customize the background and also be able to turn on or off the box shadow if you like. In typography settings, you can change any properties related to the font, headers, and body content, such as font family, variant, font height, font size, letter spacing, and colors. I will change the font family to something else. Let's pick rib eye and choose the color yellow. You can see the change on the preview. In extra features, you have the option to turn on or off right to left layout, smooth scrolling, open graph meta tags, which is used for better sharing on social networks such as Facebook, back to top button, which is here, Google theme on Android devices, and preload logo, which can be customized with your own logo too. If there is a customization that is not available on this dashboard, you can always add a custom CSS code to make it look like what you want. I will do an example here. Let's say you want to hide the header. You can add this custom CSS code to the board. Click save and publish. And you will see that the header disappeared from your website.